Yo, hey guys, what's poppin'? Jacques Slade here, back with another unboxing, and today, well, we're going to places unseen, unheard of places. Places where many sneakerheads will never ever get a chance to go. I myself have not been to this place where we are about to go, but some very lucky individuals, some individuals called revolutionaires, were able to go there. And one lucky revolutionaire came away with what's inside of this brown bag. And I know what you're thinking, Jacques, it's just a brown bag. Well, there's actually more to the brown bag because there's something inside, and it is this pair of shoes. Now, I know what you're thinking, oh Jacques, I've seen a Nike box before, so what's so special about that Nike box? Well, if you take a look at that logo right there, that alone will tell you that, That alone will tell you that this, that was good. That alone will tell you that this is something special. This is not your regular Nike box. It's not your regular orange Nike box with the Nike swoosh. As you can see, it's not even the same orange color. It has a little bit of a red tint to it, which tells you that it's something special. Not only that, the Nike and the swoosh, see all these colors here? They're representative of what's inside of this box. It's something designed by someone from your and my community, which I think is a very, very big deal. I think that bridges the gap. That takes things in different places. It gives people like you and I hope that one day we will be able to do an unboxing or do a video where we say, hey, I did this. So big shout out to Sean. And if you don't know who Sean is one of the revolutionaries picked by Nike for Air Max Day to create his own Air Max design. The community voted on the designs, and this is the shoe that won. Now, these have been releasing to the public in small batches. I was lucky enough to get my hands on a pair thanks to the good folks over at Nike. But without further ado, let's get into it so you can actually see the design and see how it looks in real life. This is the Nike Air Max 1/97 VF SW. The SW stands for Sean Wotherspoon, and I don't know what the VF stands for. I'm thinking maybe it's vintage flair. I don't know. I'm just kind of throwing that out there. Anyway, let's take a look inside the box. And what you first see is more air. For the 30th anniversary of the Air Max 1, 12 revolutionaries, which I mentioned to you before, were invited to design the future of air. The shoes were voted on by the community. The winner was Sean Wotherspoon, LA vintage store owner and lifelong Air Max fan, who brought together, I won't tell you what he brought together yet because I want you to see it on the actual shoes, but it does say that these were inspired by the 80s. They are made to be worn and they're designed to fray. The more you wear them, the better you get. And I love that sort of sentiment when it comes to sneakers. So let's see what's in the box. First, we get a little happy face patch that you can put on your clothes, on your jacket. This is from Sean, who owns a vintage store. So this sort of patch that you can put on your clothes actually makes a lot of sense. Then you get a dust bag. This is a custom dust bag, a corduroy dust bag. I don't know if you guys can hear that. This is corduroy. Yeah, so corduroy there, very, very nice. Keep that out nice and flat. And then let's get to the actual shoes, and these are nice. The Air Max 1/97. So maybe we should just call them the Air Max Sean or the Air Max Wotherspoon. I don't know. They gotta have a name, something like that. All right, so you get the patch inside the box. Then you also, looks like you get a couple sets of laces. Here's a turquoise or a light blue pair. There's a purple pair in here as well. This one has a white pair, so let's just take that off, pop that off. So this one has a white pair, and then the white pair actually comes with two patches inside of it. So you get a Nike swoosh on the yellow corduroy sort of patch with a turquoise Nike swoosh. Very, very nice if you wanted to switch out the patches. They actually have patches on the tongue. This one is a wave with a Nike swoosh underneath. So both of them are, you can switch both of those out and take those out. So let's put these over here. So those are the white. So technically you get four sets of laces when you buy these shoes. You get the yellow pair that come with the shoes, the white pair, the turquoise pair, and then there's the purple pair as well. So the shoe that he picked is the Air Max 97 or Air Max 1. I'm not sure which shoe he actually started out with, But this is a hybrid, I guess is the correct word, of those two. So it takes the Air Max 1 outsole and midsole. I'm a big fan of the Air Max 1. I love the Air Max 1 flying it right now. It's like my favorite shoe whenever I go somewhere because it's light and super comfortable. So I've been wearing that one like crazy. But then on the upper, they use the Air Max 97. And as you guys know, the Air Max 97 has been a big shoe this year. They've had gold pairs. They've had black pairs. They had the silver original OG pair drop this year. And this one combines just two really dope Air Max shoes. Now, the colors that he used are brown, yellow, green, purple, turquoise, pink, gray, and yellow on the upper. And I think these are going to look sick when they start to fray. I'm personally a big fan of a worn Air Jordan 1. I think it looks better than when they are brand new. If you wear them in just a little bit, just get a little bit of a crease. The leather starts to fray a little bit. They look warm. They look more comfortable. That's just for me. That's just my preference. And I think these are going to wear the same way. When you get a few scratches, you get a few scuffs, you get a little bit of a crease in there, these are going to look really, really solid. There's something nice about a really nicely worn pair of shoes. Now, I'm not talking about a beat up pair of shoes, but a nicely worn pair of shoes. And I think that's going to work well with these. Now, some more details that you see with these is on the inside is that this liner is almost like a, I was going to say felt or maybe like a crushed velvet or something like that, which goes back to the 80s. And I didn't read this to you guys, it's on the top of the box, but this upper, the corduroy upper, was inspired by the hats from the 80s, which Nike used to make, and they were actually corduroy hats. And then this kind of reminds me of like the couches from back then that your grandmother wouldn't let you sit on. They had this sort of velvet or crushed velvet or felt sort of material that they were made of that's super, super soft. And then that's on the back of the tongue. It's on like the inside of the liner. Then it's also on the insoles of the shoes. And speaking of the insoles, they actually have a happy face there as well with the same Nike swoosh, but it's more in the orange colorway that you usually get with a regular orange Nike box. So I think these are dope. I honestly think these are really cool. I think it's a really good looking shoe. A big shout out to Sean. Amazing that you were able to do this. And for the last details, they have VA to LA because Sean is from Virginia and now he's here in LA. And he actually has a vintage sneaker consignment shop sort of store here in Los Angeles. Anyway, so just wanted to give you guys a quick look at these. Again, I'm not sure when these are releases. I imagine they will be releasing in March of next year or maybe April of next year. I believe March of next year, but I can't confirm that. I don't know if they're going to release earlier before that. There were some early releases of these. So there are some of these actually out in the wild that got released, but I don't know when the full general release is actually going to happen. I'm hoping it happens during or around Air Max Day, but again, I don't have that information, so I'll update you guys. Make sure you follow me on Twitter, and I'll let you guys know as soon as I know about that. With that being said, I'm Jacques Slade. As always, guys, I hope you enjoy this unboxing, and make sure you stay tuned because I have another one coming for you on Thursday. I've got something for you on Wednesday, and then I'll be in London at SneakerCon, so if you're in London, make sure you come by and say hello. With that being said, guys, I appreciate you, and I'll see you soon. Big shout out to Sean. Sean, you're an inspiration. Hopefully one day I'll be there just like you. All right, man. Peace, guys.